Hello, and welcome to Controllerstech. Today, we are continuing with our STM32 IoT series, which we have been working on in the last three videos. In those earlier videos, we covered how to connect the ESP8266 module with the STM32, how to configure UART, and how to connect both STM32 and ESP8266 to a Wi-Fi network. In a most recent video, we specifically looked at how the STM32 can connect to an MQTT broker and publish messages to a topic. As I mentioned in that video, today we're going to discuss the importance of the client sending a ping request, why it is required, and also how to send it. Along with this, we will also implement FreeRTOS to publish messages to the MQTT topic. This will make the publishing process much more efficient and practical. I strongly recommend watching the previous video before this one, because I will be skipping some details that were already explained there. For this tutorial, I will be using the exact same project we created in the last video. To keep things organized, let's rename the project as Part 4. This helps maintain clarity as we move through the series. Make sure you also update the references so that the IDE can automatically adjust the name in all the relevant places. All right, the renaming process is now complete. Next, let's check the ESP8266 STM32.c file. At the moment, there are no additional functions in it. However, you might recall that the ESP-MQTT ping function was already included in the project during the previous tutorial. We didn't go into details about it back then, but now we will. So, before we move on to actually using the ping request, let's first take a moment to understand why it is necessary in the first place. Let's take an example where we want to transmit data at longer intervals, such as once every minute or even once every hour. To achieve this, I'm going to use a timer that will trigger an interrupt at these larger time intervals. So, let's begin by configuring this timer. For this demonstration, I will use timer 1. We will set its clock source to the internal clock, and for the trigger event selection, we will choose update event. Next, we need to configure the prescaler and the auto reload register, ARR, so that the timer generates interrupts at a much slower rate, instead of running at its default high frequency. Before doing that, let's quickly take a look at the clock configuration. All timers in STM32 are connected to either the APB1 or APB2 bus. The timers on these two buses run on different clock frequencies. This means you need to know which bus your timer belongs to. You can find this information in the datasheet of your specific STM32 device. For example, in the STM32F4 series, timer 1 is connected to the APB2 bus, as shown in this image. If you're having trouble locating this in your datasheet, there is also another option. You can reconfigure the APB prescalers so that both APB1 and APB2 clocks run at the same frequency. In my case, I have configured both APB clocks to run at 90 MHz. This means that regardless of which timer I select, the timer clock will always be the same, 90 MHz. Now, since the timer is running at 90 MHz, I can use a prescaler value of 45,000 along with an auto reload value of 60,000. This configuration will slow down the timer clock to approximately 0.033 Hz. In simpler terms, it will take around 30 seconds for the timer to complete one full count cycle, which means the interrupt will be triggered every 30 seconds. If you find this calculation a bit confusing, I recommend watching the timer series linked in the top right corner, where this concept is explained in detail. Finally, we also need to enable the timer interrupt in the NVSC tab. That's all we need to do for the timer configuration. Once done, simply click Save to generate the project files. Now that the configuration is complete, let's move ahead and continue writing the code. Let's begin by commenting out the Wi-Fi connection code. Since the ESP module is already connected to Wi-Fi from the previous project, running this step again only takes extra time and is not needed here. Now, once the STM32 client has successfully connected to the MQTT broker, We can start the timer in interrupt mode. The timer will begin counting from zero. After 30 seconds, it will reach the top value, and at that moment, an interrupt will be triggered. This interrupt will call the period elapsed callback function. This callback will be executed every 30 seconds. But since I want to send data every full minute, we need to adjust this behavior. To achieve this, I've defined another variable that increments each time the callback is called. After two calls, the value of this variable will always be a multiple of two. We can use this to set another flag variable, which I've called isTriggered. It's important to note that the keepAlive time is currently set to 60 seconds. This is the duration for which the broker will keep the connection active, even if no data is sent from the client. For this example, let's reduce the keepAlive time to 30 seconds. Don't worry if this seems confusing right now. It will make more sense in a moment. Inside the main while loop, we will wrap the publish function inside an if statement. This way, publishing will only occur when the isTriggered variable is set, which will effectively happen once every minute. Once the publish is successful, we reset the variable so that publishing doesn't happen again until the next full minute. I think you now understand the approach we are using here. The timer interrupt occurs every 30 seconds, and with the additional variable logic, STM32 publishes once per minute. However, since the keepAlive interval is set to 30 seconds, the broker still expects some kind of activity from the client within this period. Let's go ahead and build the project. The build is successful, so we are ready to flash it. Before flashing, let's quickly review the hardware connections. The setup is exactly the same as in the previous video. The ESP module is connected via UART, and another UART is used for the USB to TTL module. Additionally, I've connected a logic analyzer to monitor the communication between the ESP module and the STM32. Now, let's build and flash the project to the board. I've already configured the serial analyzers for both the TX and RX pins. Next, open the serial console so we can view the logs. The ESP module has initialized successfully, and now the client is attempting to register with the broker. The broker accepts the connection, and the timer has started running. Since the publish interval is 1 minute, the client won't send any data immediately. Let's observe what happens after 30 seconds. Here, you can see that the ESP has received some information from the server. We'll discuss this in detail shortly. After 1 minute, the client attempts to publish a message. However, it fails to do so. Let's check why this is happening. The client queries the connection status, but the ESP responds with status 4, which indicates that the module is not connected to the broker. Because of this, the client does not send a message. Looking at the logs, just before this point, you can see a closed message sent by the ESP module. This was actually from the broker, indicating that it has terminated the connection due to inactivity. Here's what really happened. The client had set the keepAlive interval to 30 seconds. The broker allows about 1.5 times this duration, around 45 seconds. If the client does not send anything within this time, the broker closes the connection. To handle this, let's initialize the isTriggered variable with a starting value of 1. This way, the client will at least publish one message immediately after connecting. Let's build and flash the code again. This time, the client successfully publishes its first message to the broker. After this, STM32 will wait for the timer interrupt before publishing the next one. But once again, the broker closes the connection because there was no activity within the keepAlive interval. To solve this issue, we can make the client send ping requests while it is waiting for the timer interrupt. This will keep the connection alive until it's time to publish the next message. Let's now check the MQTT documentation for more details about the ping request. As explained here, the ping request is used to let the server know that the client is still alive and connected. The structure is quite simple. The first byte of the fixed header is 0xc0, and the remaining length is 0 bytes. Since the ping request packet does not contain any variable header or payload, the remaining length stays at zero. Inside the ESP MQTT ping function, we handle this by first informing the ESP that we are going to send 2 bytes. After sending them, we wait for the acknowledgement from the server. The server responds with an acknowledgement by sending 0xd0 followed by 0x00. This confirms that the ping request has been received successfully. Now, let's move on to writing the code for this. First, define a 32-bit variable to store the last tick value. Inside the main while loop, we will continuously check if more than 20 seconds have passed since the last ping was sent. If more than 20 seconds have elapsed, we will send another ping request to the server and update the last ping variable. This way, the next check will again be based on the new tick value. With this setup, during the 1-minute wait cycle for publishing data, the client will continue to send ping requests at regular intervals to keep the connection alive. Now, let's test it out. To verify the messages, let's also open the MQTT Explorer. Here, you can clearly see that the first message has been successfully published by the STM32 client, and it is visible on the MQTT Explorer. While the STM32 is waiting for the timer interrupt, the client is actively sending ping requests to maintain the connection with the broker. If 20 seconds pass and the interrupt has not yet occurred, the client will send another ping request automatically. Finally, when the timer interrupt triggers, the client publishes a new message to the topic. On the MQTT Explorer, you can see this message with the updated count value. After that, the cycle continues again, with the client sending ping requests in between the publish intervals. One thing to keep in mind is that we're using a public broker here. Public brokers sometimes close connections unexpectedly, even if everything is working fine. I encountered this issue a few times while testing the code. That's why it's a good practice to implement a reconnection function to handle the situation where the connection to the broker is lost. So, I hope you now clearly understand how the ping request works, why it is needed, and how to implement it in your STM32 MQTT project. Now, we will see how to implement FreeRTOS so that we can publish messages to different topics. Let's start by opening CubeMX to configure FreeRTOS. First, open the FreeRTOS settings and enable CMSJS version 2. We'll leave most of the configuration at default for now, and then move on to the tasks and queue section. By default, one task is already created here. Let's rename this task to MQTT task. Its priority should be set to normal, and we'll also change the entry function to start MQTT task. To make sure the task has enough memory, let's increase its stack size to 512 words. Next, we will create 2 new tasks. Which will be responsible for publishing messages to 2 different topics. Make sure to assign these tasks a lower priority than the MQTT task. This ensures that while MQTT task is handling publishing, the other tasks cannot preempt or interrupt it. We also need to create a queue for message publishing. Later in the code, we'll make use of a structured queue, but for now, we'll keep it simple. Set the data size to 16 bits, and the queue size to 4, since we only have 2 tasks that will be sending data into this queue. Next, enable the nullib reentrant option. This provides a thread-safe version of the nullib functions for use with FreeRTOS. It's important when working with multiple tasks. Another key change we need to make is in the time base source. Instead of using systick, we will assign a different timer. This helps maintain accurate HAL timing, especially when systick may not be suitable due to low power modes. For this project, I'm using timer 6 as the systick source. That's all we need to configure here. Click Save to generate the project again. All right, the first step is to define the structure for the queue. This structure will hold both the topic and the message arrays. The publish tasks will prepare this data and then pass it on to the MQTT task through the queue. Next, locate the part of the code where the queue is created. Here, We need to update the item size to match the structure we just defined. If you want to dive deeper into free RTOS concepts, you can check out the STM32 free RTOS playlist linked in the top right corner. Now, let's scroll down to the Publish task. Inside this task, define the structure that will be used to send data to the queue. Along with it, also create a count variable which will update after each transmission. Inside the infinite loop of this task, load the topic name and message into the structure. After that, update the count variable so that the next time the loop runs, a new value is loaded. Once the structure is ready, call the function osMessageQueuePut to place it into the queue. Finally, add a 10-second delay for this infinite loop. We will repeat the same process for Publish Task 2, but with a small difference. Here, instead of incrementing, we will decrease the count value starting from 1,000. This task will publish messages to a different topic. With this, our Publish tasks are ready. Now let's move on to writing the MQTT task. Inside this task, also define the same structure, but this time will be used to receive data from the queue. In the infinite loop of the MQTT task, check if the publish queue contains any messages. If it does, receive the message and store it in the structure. The data is now available in the message structure, so we can call the MQTT publish function to send this message to the respective topic. Before publishing, make sure to verify the connection state. The message should only be published if the ESP module is still connected to the broker. We also need to add the ping request function here. To do that, define a variable to keep track of the time since the last ping. Inside the infinite loop, add a condition to check if more than 20 seconds have passed since the last ping. If so, send a new ping request to the broker. Additionally, if the module has been disconnected from the broker, we should send another connection request, just like we did earlier in the bare metal implementation. That completes the code changes. Let's now build a project. At this point, we see an error with the time period elapsed function. The function is being called twice, so let's simply comment out the older one. Now, rebuild and flash the project to the board. Although the while loop doesn't run in RTOS, let's comment it out anyway for clarity. Next, open the serial console to view the logs, and at the same time, check the MQTT Explorer, which is already subscribed to both topics. As you can see, messages are now being published from both tasks. This means our STM32 as an MQTT client is working perfectly with free RTOS as well. We are able to publish messages from multiple tasks by passing them into a common MQTT task using the queue. That's all for this video. I hope you now understand how ping requests are used by the client and also how to implement RTOS to publish messages to different topics. In the next video of this series, we will take it further by learning how to subscribe to a topic and use the receive messages directly on the STM32 microcontroller. That's it for today. You can download the full project from the link given in the description of this video. If you have any doubts, feel free to leave a comment. Keep watching, and have a great day ahead.